Jack, unfortunately, gets taken advantage of quite a bit. Even quite early on in the film, a monk, of all people, rips him off and steals his horse, trying to swap them for magic beans. And Jack's a trusting guy. Mm. And he thinks the best of the monk, but he makes him look a bit silly. And he gets told off terribly by his uncle. And that happens a fair bit. He's made to feel useless. But luckily, he gets the opportunity to kind of prove himself on this journey.
Also, both characters are surviving without either both their parents or one of them. You know, my mum is dead, and both of Jack's parents are dead. So there's a definite kind of history of kind of upset and mistrust and missing them and wanting to kind of do good and stick by them and become something and not just kind of, you know, remembering them and what they brought to them. That's how they came to know the story of the giants, is because of their parents. You know, my mum used to read it to me and his dad reads it to him. So they're both, they both hasn't had an easy ride, so yeah. I use people like Sigourney Weaver as inspiration because I think she's a very strong woman, and I wanted to kind of bring aspects of that. And also, I'm pretty feisty myself, so you know, I wanted to kind of bring aspects of that. I didn't want her to be at all conventional. I didn't want her to be combing her hair all the time and kind of looking pretty. And particularly, I even spoke to Joanna Johnston about the costume design for Isabel when she runs away. I wanted that to be boyish and ripped and tattered and still with that fairy tale aspect, which Joanna has amazingly captured. But I wanted her to be a little bit rough and ready and not quite so pristine as all princesses tend to be.
It's just a different form of acting, you know, with the green screen. It's a lot of trust in other people and them explaining what will be there and the timings of everything, so that you can kind of relate to those and not look stupid when you finally watch the screen and realize that you're not reacting to what you thought you were and at the right time. And then the motion capture is just, you know, we were involved with that, but I think the phenomenal thing on that is managing to see how subtle a performance someone like Bill Nighy can give, but then see that transformed onto the lead giant's face and features, and that's something that's really spectacular to see.
Oh God, I mean, it's just been the most fantastic roller coaster from day one. I've loved every second of it, and yeah, when I saw the final product, I couldn't believe it was me. I was like, wow, I actually did that. It looks so cool. And then, you know, just seeing everything, the special effects and everything put together and everyone's performances and our relationships with each other, it just makes a really kind of special movie. And I really enjoyed it.
I mean, when it all comes together, you know, you're never quite sure how things are working when you're on set. You know, you can have the best time making a film, but sometimes it doesn't translate onto screen, this one I think it does. I think it's a really fun adventure, and that's what we had making the film.